disorder is characterized by recurrent, unexpected panic attacks. Panic attacks, which are the building blocks of panic disorder, are defined in the DSM-5 as an intense, abrupt surge of intense fear or intense discomfort that reaches a peak within minutes. A panic attack involves four or more of the following symptoms, which, as you will see, are mainly physiological sensations: palpitations, pounding heart or accelerated heart rate, sweating, trembling or shaking, sensations of shortness of breath or smothering, feelings of choking, chest pain or discomfort, nausea or abdominal distress, feeling dizzy, unsteady, lightheaded or faint, chills or heat sensations, paresthesias, which is numbness or tingling sensations, derealization, which is feelings of unreality, or depersonalization, which is a sense of being detached from oneself, fear of losing control or going crazy, and fear of dying. To meet the criteria for panic disorder, at least one panic attack must have been followed by at least a month of either or both of the following: persistent anticipatory anxiety or concern about having another attack or the consequences of having another attack, and/or a significant and problematic behavioural change related to the attack. For example, avoiding any form of exercise because the person believes that exercise might induce a panic attack. Let me just explain what we mean when we talk about anxiety about having an attack or the consequences of having an attack. Generally, this anxiety relates to the tendency of people with panic disorder to misinterpret the physical sensations they are experiencing. For almost all of us, when we become anxious, we experience physiological symptoms of anxiety. Some people get sweaty palms, others experience a racing heart or a sense of nausea. Trembling is also common. Each of these physical responses is a very normal physiological sign of anxiety, but they are also symptoms of a panic attack. When a person is having a panic attack and they notice that their heart is beating faster than usual, they don't think to themselves, the reason my heart is racing is that I'm anxious. Instead, they think to themselves, my heart is beating so fast, I must be having a heart attack. So, the physiological symptoms that are literally part of the definition of this disorder tend to be interpreted in a catastrophic way in terms of physical health. Another common misinterpretation that people with panic disorder make is to think that their symptoms mean that they are going crazy or losing control. As with the other anxiety disorders, we have exclusion criteria to ensure that the symptoms of panic disorder are not better accounted for by either another mental illness or the physiological effects of substance use or a medical condition. Typically, by the time somebody with panic disorder ends up seeing a mental health professional, they've done the rounds in terms of various medical specialists. Often, people with panic disorder are pretty unhappy to be seeing a mental health professional. I've had people say to me, I'm here because my GP insisted. Just because the cardiologists couldn't find the problem, they all think that my symptoms aren't real, that they're in my head and I need therapy. I don't need therapy, I just need a good cardiologist. One important point to emphasise about this is that with panic disorder, the physical symptoms are real, they're not in the person's head. The problem is in how the person is making sense of these physical symptoms. In terms of the 12-month prevalence rate, we're looking at around about a 2 to 3% rate across adolescents and adults. Panic disorder is not commonly seen in children and tends to be diagnosed about twice as often in females as in males.